This talk is regarding, let's say, the OpenFOAM framework and HPC. What is this state-of-the-art and what are the perspective in ExaFOAM perspective? This is, let's say, a wrap-up of the activity we are doing, a follow-up what we are starting to do in ExaFOAM. And this activity has been done by previous PRACE project and will be funded by ExaFOAM. This is the table of contents. I'm going to give you a very brief overview of what is the OpenFOAM framework, what are the actual HPC performances, and what are the bottleneck, what we are doing in the HPC technical committee to work, overcome, or alleviate this bottleneck, and this will, let's say, rework all together as a community in the ExaFOAM project. After, I'm going to show you one of the activity of the technical committee, that is the HPC benchmark project. At the end, a few slides regarding the GPUs activity that are ongoing. OpenFOAM, let's say, it stands for Open Source Field Operation and Manipulation. Let's say it's a free open source CFD software, primarily developed by OpenCFD since 2004. There are three main variants of the code: the ESI OpenCFD, that is the .com version. There is released every 6 months. We are for the moment at the version 2012. The second version is released by CFD Direct, the .org. We are at the OpenFOAM.8. And the third version is the version from the extended community. And this is, if I remember, 3.4 dot something. Let's say, what is, let's say, OpenFOAM? Is a sort of, let's say, framework to solve any type of PDE, partial differential equation, thanks to some, let's say, style that mimics the operation of the basic mathematical operator, divergence, rotor, and so on. The main characteristic is that it is written in metaprogramming C++, and from the numerical point of view, it is an unstructured finite volume solver. Is pure MPI, it is based on domain decomposition. Let's say it can be used for any type of, let's say, physics, but these characteristics are very useful for solving problems where there are very large gradient variation with shock, and this is very useful for computational fluid dynamics. And essentially, OpenFOAM is the de facto standard for open source CFD in HPC. It has a large base of users, and it is one of the five most used HPC CFD code up to date. OpenFOAM HPC performances. Is OpenFOAM ready for pre-exascaling? The short answer is not. OpenFOAM scales reasonably well up to 1,000 core. Upper limit is order of thousands of core. To do this, we have, let's say, to tune the application and the hardware. We have, let's say, to use the exact number of code, we have to use the exact number of MPI, we have to use the tune our application, and we can achieve a good result. You can see on the left-hand side, driven with 64 million of core on the left-hand side, done by Giorgio Amati on old but good KNL Marconi. Custom version by Shimizu in Japan is a very good example of, let's say, co-design. This is a real bi-directional co-design, in that the Fujitsu processor was custom for the application. Also, the interconnect was the tofu. Was customized for this type of application, and so and they achieve, let's say, very good performances. This is the best weak scaling performance that we have up to date. It is almost, let's say, 100 billion cell on, let's say, 50,000 core. And this is what we want to achieve, let's say, in a large scale when we deal with some type of code. I want just to mention co-design fashion that this co-design brings not only benefit for the hardware, but some of the software enhancement. It was taken back to the code, and there was one optimization of the MPI topology done in version 18.06, if I remember. Last improvement has been done by the add-on done by Pezzi. Perform. That is the work done by Cineca in collaboration with the Pezzi team and ESI. And this is a library to plug in Pezzi and any type of external linear algebra solver dependency into OpenFOAM. Let's say we achieve very good performances up to order of, let's say, 4,000 core. You can see on the right-hand side. Let's say if we talk about performances, it's worldwide to cite the roofline model. Roofline model is a visual performance model when you have on the x-axis the arithmetic intensity, that is the number of flops per byte, when you have on the y-axis the performance, that is the flop. Let's say you can see on the top of the plot the, let's say, the roof line of different, I think it's 10 years of HPC we have in Cineca, and you can see there is an increase of the performances both on the Y axis on the and also on the X axis on the top to the right. But what about real application? Unfortunately, in real life, it's on the bottom left corner of the plot. So let's say the arithmetic intensity of, let's say, the CFD code is very poor, less than 0.1, when we can get the best arithmetic intensity, when we get, let's say, with BLAS or dense linear algebra, dense linear algebra multiplication like BLAS, but we are still order of one. So, as you can see from this plot, there is a very visual mismatch by the exascaling race, where we are going to the top right, a real application where we are limited to usually memory bounded range, but in any case, we are on the top left. So, we can, let's say, suggest some tuning for application, but this is, let's say, it's not a co-design. I mean, for me, this is optimization. What we can do, we can try to work on this, let's say, bottleneck. Okay, now you have seen what is the trend of the exascale race use order of millions of core with heterogeneous cluster, where, let's say, the GPUs will be the most, let's say, part of the computational power of our machine, let's say. Okay, I don't want to go on the technical details now. Most of you know what are different classes, what are the different, let's say, specs of each cluster and GPU CPUs. I want just to mention what are, let's say, the well-known bottleneck of OpenFOAM. Let's say, but I can also say most of the CFD code have this type of bottleneck. That is, let's say, a community effort that we have to overcome to, if you want to achieve to use in a good way this big monster that we will have in very few months, few years. Let's say one of the issue is the scalability of the linear algebra solver. Let's say we need a new linear algebra solver. We need optimized linear algebra solver that has to be used for heterogeneous multi-many core. Another bottleneck, and this is for OpenFOAM, that's the sparse merge storage format. It is used the old-fashioned LDU merge storage format. This type of format does not enable any type of cache blocking mechanism, virtualization, SDA, or the, let's say, characteristics that we have in all the new processors, starting from Avix of Intel up to SVE of the ARM, but also using the cache inside the GPUs. That is very, very efficient. Another issue for the, let's say, pre-exascaling application are the I/O. I/O, when we are going to millions of cores, is a bottleneck. And so we are, let's say, already working on that. To overcome this, as a community, we work with in two aspects. First of all, one is the HPC technical committee. What is the technical committee? Let's say in the OpenFOAM governance, there are different technical committees that cover different key focus areas of OpenFOAM. I am the chairman of the HPC technical committee for OpenFOAM, and we have different remits. Let's say we want mainly to work together with community to overcome the actual HPC bottleneck OpenFOAM. I have just put here a list, but this is a sort of wish list. This is a medium or long-term vision that we want to work on. And of course, we want to work in a co-design fashion. Let's say if our co-design is unilateral co-design. So let's say we do not aim to have, let's say, dedicated chipset of hardware, but we want, let's say, to maximize the use of all the new different architecture processor chip available to the market. Of course, there are a lot of priority, and we are, let's say, for the moment, working on a couple of two. One is the HPC benchmark, and the second one is let's say, is GPU enabling OpenFOAM, but this started linear algebra solver plugin of OpenFOAM, let's say. I want to mention that there is also an activity with the parallel I/O. One is the I/O secure library from Oak Ridge that is a native parallel I/O system that is now available in OpenFOAM, and there is also the collated file format in the .org version. Okay, ExaFOAM. What is ExaFOAM? ExaFOAM is a consortium consisting of a well-balanced group of experts to work on the co-design of OpenFOAM targeting pre- and exascaling HPC architecture. We have a successful bid for the Core 03 2019 of EuroChipC under the umbrella of industrial software codes for extreme scale computing environment, and and application. This is our, let's say, some bureaucratic details. I want to focus more on the challenge. And what we want to work on is we want to enable the open form community to exploit efficiently and truly the current and evolving HPC hardware and middleware. We seek synergy with the expert open source center knowledge, including using of novel mathematical method and algo. What is the scope we want to improve? Industrial software and codes based on the open form technology for industrial users to fully exploit new and emerging HPC hardware. We want to work on different aspects ranging from algorithm, implementation, efficiency, refactoring, and port optimization. Let's say it's an ambitious goal. And we have, let's say, to do this, we have, let's say, we work on this type of work plan. The idea is just to have a series of benchmarks given by some industry that will provide us different sizes of benchmark with different application domain. We will work on code design, profiling performance, and after this analysis, we will split our work into main branches. One will be the evolutionary development, where we are going to put on the existing, let's say, framework, new feature, new plugin, for example, Linear Algebra Solver, Parallel.io, porting to GPU, load balancing, and so on. Second one is, let's say, the refactoring, or let's say, let's call revolutionary, where we are going to rebuild the basic building block of the structured finite volume when we want to start from a new data structure that will be, let's say, suitable for a new type of architecture where we want to exploit at best the new type of, let's say, co-heterogeneous system based on CPU, GPUs, and new architecture. Based on that, we are going to rewrite, let's say, a new kernel, a mini app that will exploit at best the new architecture. That's more or less the big framework. The consortium consists of 12 partners from seven European countries. The PI is ESI OpenCFD, plant-based, and there are the most of the HPC center in Europe. There are the more almost all the open form developer in Europe, the open form users. We have also expert in algo, we have expert in also in application and so on. You can see here all the list. We do believe in industrial support, and when we have written the proposal, we ask for supporter and stakeholder. Supporter are entities, organizations that support this with vendor support. Stakeholder make a real commitment with internal resources, with the cases or some effort during our proposal and now also during the project phase. You can see here the list of the some, let's say, from big industry, automotive, from OEM to research center, and so on. Budget is medium size for a European project, is a EuroChipC side, so is a joint undertaking. And we are going to start in 2 months. First of April, we are for the moment in the process of signing the grant agreement. Duration is 3 months, 3 years, sorry. And this is more or less the umbrella. From the technical point of view, what we are doing in the HPC Technical Committee we are starting to create a code repository for the HPC test cases. So the idea is to create an open and shared repository with the relevant dataset test case, so that we can give to the user a user guide, script, and setup to have an ethology, term of reference in term of comparison from software and hardware based on the same framework, that is OpenFOAM. Of course, this exercise is very big, so we want, first of all, to, let's say, focus ourselves on some KPI, key performance indicator, to measure some sort of performances. Everything is public and it is available for download here. And this is the research test case that is going to, it's a work in progress and will be, let's say, an ongoing work in progress. In the sense that most of the stakeholders committed themselves to put this test case publicly available during or after the ExtraFOAM project. For the moment, we have started with a couple of test cases. One is a standard driven cavity, the second is a motorbike, the third one will be maybe presented tomorrow by the CHISE consortium. We have different sizes for each test case, and we want to, let's say, focus on given physical features, starting from something very, let's say, easy and increasing in complexity. But what we want to achieve, we want to measure the some co-design KPI. So we want to have a relation between hardware and software. For example, we are focused on the driven cavity, that is where the real bottleneck is the linear algebra solver, and let's say our KPI is the time to solution and the time spent in linear algebra, and this is where we are focused for the moment. Let's say, okay, this is the first test case. I've already talked a little. This is a very well-known test case, a very simple geometry. It's derived from the 2D driven cavity open form. Very simple geometry, only hexahedra, increasing size by only doubling the number of mesh size per linear cube. What is it? Is let's say it's a Poisson solver. It's a stress test for linear algebra solver. Everything mainly is a pressure equation. So we want to measure, let's say, work time and memory bandwidth, and we want to see how performing the linear algebra solver. That's the concept for this test case. The second one is just step forward on this direction. So what we have an HPC version of the motorbike. It's been developed from the well-known motorbike tutorial. Now we have a final mesh respect to the tutorial, and let's say we have not touched the basic snappy. And what we do essentially, we are going to increase the number of cell without changing mesh topology by simply mirroring the domain. So we can have one, two, four motorbike, and this is a very, let's say, suitable because the cell size are kept the same size. So no need to change the setup. So we can focus on computational aspect, and this is very suitable for weak scaling at a large scale. That's the idea. Very quick, we have to have a look to your linear algebra solver, your setup, and which type of linear algebra solver are you using. On this case, we usually you have to use the fixed norm when the X norm is fixed, and you have to check that you are already on the steady state configuration if you are running your benchmark. We are also starting to have an HPC hardware comparison. This is an initial list of hardware we are running. These activities still ongoing, and it is done by a different member of the HPC technical committee. I have no, let's say, update on this because it's a work in progress. For the moment, we are trying to run the, let's say, the data-driven by different members of the consortium. For the moment, there is, let's say, the member of the consortium that are working together are Cineca with, let's say, Power and Intel machine, E4 with ARM architecture, Amazon Web Service with all the Amazon, let's say, hardware, and Huawei with the new ARM chipset. So we are working all together to try to define this benchmark comparison. Another word regarding the profiling. Before you start to make your analysis and your and see what are your bottleneck, I believe that we have to see in our in the face what is the computational aspect of our application. This is the profiling of the driven cavity with size M, that is 80 millions, with a fixed iteration setup. For fixed norm, it's more or less equivalent. As you can see, there's a slow scaling for the by increasing the number of node. Let's say we are profiling this with Intel APS. As you can see, we're increasing the number of nodes. We have a big increase in number of MPI, up to 25%. Most of the time is spent in MPI all-to-all, and this is given by the linear algebra solver. But the most, let's say, significant plot is on the right-hand side. That is, let's say, the time spent in different function. As you can see, let's say the linear algebra solver is, let's say, is almost the total part of the computational time. And of this linear algebra solver, most of the time is spent on pressure. So our bottleneck is pressure is a linear algebra solver. If we move to a different test case, we use the HPC motorbike size S, that is, let's say, equivalent to the lid-driven cavity M. So we are order of 7-8 million of core. You can see there is a similar trend in terms of strong scaling when we are increasing the number, the MPI communication. And before regarding CPU timing distribution, this is done with one node, but a similar trend we have with more node. And let's say, as you can see now, the time is dominated by the linear algebra solver, but now there is, let's say, almost 9% is spent in Matrix assembly. And this Matrix assembly is, if you can see the plot below, is given by essentially the two components, the mesh that is not no more uniform, and the turbulence modeling that now has an effect. So before starting to make your optimization, you have to profile your application. Probably tomorrow you will see with the cheese application in this application is ASCII. In that case, different application give you different, let's say, computational time division. In that case, half of the time is spent in Matrix assembly. And so in that case, you cannot, let's say, your performance gain change according to this profiling. Another, this is a plot regarding the strong scaling of these two test cases by increasing the number of nodes comparing it to the, let's say, linear. As you can see, there is a similar trend, and essentially both of them are super linear effect by using the same setup. What is the superlinear effect usually is given by, let's say, a not very well tuned baseline reference test case. In fact, we can see here that is on the right hand side, we have the plot of the bound, percent of a bound, that is essentially that is a measure of the memory bandwidth. That is how much of the memory bandwidth available we use. As you can see, we are almost using all the memory bandwidth in such a configuration. So we are heavily memory bounded. And this is typically when you have, let's say, a big number of cells per core. And this explains this superlinear effect that we have. And we have started this exercise for comparison of a different cluster, and these are very preliminary plot for the moment. When we are trying to make an objective and super partes comparison of different hardware in different aspects. We have for the moment, let's say, these are ARM and old Broadwell, and you can see there is a similar trend among the two clusters when using the same lead-driven XTEL test cases. Now I want to just conclude with the GPU porting activity. This is just, let's say, a very quick overview. Tomorrow, Simone is going to give you, let's say, more technical details about that. We have released the PetC4Form library. It is a library for OpenFOAM that provides a solver for embedding the PET and all its external dependencies, that is hype, ML, and so on, into any type of OpenFOAM simulation. Let's say on the left hand side, we have the scalar, the CPU test done up to 4000 core. We have with the red column, green column is the PetC multi-grid solver that, let's say, is the by far the most efficient comparing to the all the other, let's say, solver with this dimension. We are running a new test case with a bigger mesh, that is XXL, that is 216 million of core. Thanks to the PetC4Form library, we can also, let's say, use all the development done by the PetC team. For the moment, we are also comparing the native OpenFOAM against the multi-grid native available in OpenFOAM, in PetC. So the idea is to use all the effort done by the community, that is the PetC community, that's going to the GPU porting. Let's say we have a preliminary result. You can see here result of Skylake plus 1 Volta 100, and this is for pressure solver breakdown. For the moment, is order of 2x the time improvement. But this is a very preliminary result. For the moment, we focus on the profiling and bottleneck. Our let's say aim is not, let's say, for the moment, time to solution, but work on the optimization of the library. On this side, we are also working together with NVIDIA on the same activity. In that case, we are, let's say, using a native library provided by NVIDIA, that is the AMGX Linear Algebra Solver. It is an open source iterative library that is special focus for a multi-grid method. Let's say AMGX provides GPU support, And we can use, we have, let's say, plugin Wrapper that adapts MGX interface to accept PET-C data structure. This work is done together with NVIDIA and Kineka. And for the moment, let's say, we have good preliminary result in terms of a single GPU speedup for patch solver. And we know that the bottleneck is given by the Mares assembly, and we are, let's say, in a development phase together with, let's say, NVIDIA, and of course also with PET-C team to try to, let's say, harmonize this work to provide to the community a library that can be used for your own purpose. That's one of our, let's say, mid-term aim. I want to just conclude with another type of GPU acceleration that is done one of the partner of the Hexafome, that is the Politecnico Milano, the Department of Aerospace. And in that case, they use GPU to offload the special physics. In that case, the GPU is used only to accelerate turbulent combustion reactive flow. So let's say the cold flow is done on CPU, the reactive flow is done on GPUs. And there are, let's see, you can see here some result from ongoing paper that is going to be published. And let's say the hybrid version, let's say, have a very one order of magnitude speed up of the solution of the reacting CFD simulation. There is a very good speed up, and when compared to the whole simulation, the speed up is order of five pairs. And this is increased with the complexity of the problem. And this is another, let's say, very interesting implementation that will be further developed during the Hexafome. And that's all from my side. That's a quick overview of what are the activities of co-design in some sort in open form.